The scraping you heard, if you heard it, is from it's from my boots. Yeah, it's from my boots, nothing else. What's up? It's the German here, and it's been a long time since I've done a video. So I thought I would just show you guys my morning commute to work. Albeit slightly shortened and time-lapsed because I'm on the highway for a little bit. But yeah, you'll see how I get to work. Simples.
Put your arms around me, baby. Can't you see I need you so? Hold me close against your skin. I'm about to begin loving you. Spit on your hand and stroke my cock at a medium pace. Play with my balls and tell me how big they are. Honey, rub your beaver up and down my face. Sit on the corner of the bed and watch me whack off. You see that shampoo bottle now? Stick it up my ass. Push it in and out at a medium pace. Talk about your old boyfriend's dick and how big it was. Now shave off my pubes and punch me in the face.
Alright, so that's the boring part of my morning commute done. Now we have a bit of residential streets, and then comes the fun part. You can see where I'm heading towards. The people in the Gold Coast know what road I'm doing. For those of you that don't, this is the, I can't remember what it's called, the Robina Springbrook Road or something? Something, I don't know, the road to Springbrook. I have no idea what it's called.
Take the shampoo bottle out of my ass. Pretend I'm the pizza delivery guy and watch me whack off. Strap on a dildo and make me give you head. Tell me to slow down and do it at a medium pace. Oh, I feel so humiliated. I'm about to blow my load.
Alright, and this is where the fun part begins.
You tell me it's time to make love, but now I can't cause I spewed all over myself.
Then you look into my eyes, and you realize how much I enjoy.
A little bit slower here because there's a few residences. sticks and leaves all over these roads if there's been a bit of wind, and there has been in the last couple of days. These corners are fucking dodgy as shit, bumpy. Ugh. Nice relaxed cruising pace. I am going to work after all. Not wearing too much safety, well, not wearing my leathers. This is a public road after all, so no crazy speeding. The fun part are the corners. Ow! And it's a bit bumpy at times. I do most of it in fourth gear, but there are points where I have to drop down into third or second at the hairpins. It's just a nice cruising sort of ride into work. It's a lot better than staying on the highway, and at least it stops my tyres from spurring out too much. And it's a nice little route. The road is brilliant. Like, most of the surfacing is pretty good. There are a bit dodgy bits. There are a few dodgy bits here and there. There's a couple of wooden bridges which are coming up now, which you'll see, which are a bit dodgy as well, but I just slow right down for them and it's fine. No point in going too fast here, because all that'll end up happening is you just catch up with traffic in front of you. So this is one of the bridges here. I just slow right down. There's no point going fast over this. Oh, dodgy piece of crap. Plus there's always cars coming the other way. But it is indeed a beautiful way to start the day. Every time I go this way, I have a brilliant smile on my face. That corner shit. There's a bit of dodginess on the outside there, a couple of leaves and sticks. So I had to stay in close to the line. Not a good way to enter a corner. But made up for it by braking a bit more, slowing down a bit. So as not to go too wide. I see a few dodgy bits here and there as well. Another bridge, slow right down. That's the other thing, cyclists are on this road too. Like, I don't know how they go up this hill, it's fucking steep. turns into a one lane, so you gotta slow right down, make sure no one's coming, and just chill. It's a bit dodgy here as well, they got rock slides, and this part's usually wet and mossy. But when you're done with it, give the cyclists as much space as I can. Hey look, they're just trying to get fit and have their own sort of fun. Climb up the roads. This corner coming up is a bit dodgy as well. It's heaps of moss on this and water, so I slow down because, yeah. Don't want to be hitting a rock wall. And this one is usually, dodgy as well, not to mention there's lots of bumps in it. Slow down as well because fucking cars go over the lines. Oh, and it's bumpy. And I'm coming up to a residential area again. Part one, well, the first half of my interesting part of my morning commute. So if you haven't noticed, guys, I've got a new helmet as well. It's a Schubert E1, loving it. It's good fun. Beautiful from up here. Now this road's a little bit more dodgy than the last one. It's not as well maintained, the road surface is a bit rougher and it's got a lot of little granules in it, so I don't go anywhere near as fast on this as I do on the other one. Plus it's more of an, what would you call it, I guess a farming access route. Like, there's a lot of farms along this road, nothing much else, so... And it's very, very, very steep. I don't like going downhill. It just puts me off. I can't do it quickly. It just feels dodgy going downhill on a corner. Especially when there's shit like that all over the roads. Oh! And yeah, it's a bit bumpy as well. The corner's left and it's going like that, so it just feels terrible going down this hill. Up is not too bad, Up is actually quite fun. It's like a hill climb because it's so fucking steep. Like, you can just fucking drive and, you don't need to touch it. This is in fourth idling down, and I would still be accelerating if I was on stock gearing. I've got two extra teeth in my rear sprocket, so it gives me a bit more. Actually, no, I did decelerating. I don't know, fucking. Steep cliffs either side. Do not want to come up here. Grade. It's steep. Whoa. But there is always shit on these roads, so I do tend to take it a bit slower. A lot of farming trucks come up here carrying dirt and stuff and saw wood and what, God knows what else. They can't help it, they drop stuff on the road, so... And this corner's dodgy, this is not marked well enough. You have to actually slow down quite a bit for this one. And I've no idea what this road is called. I think it's like a loop road or something, or I don't know. Somebody will find out what it's called and let everyone know. And because of the quick decrease in elevation, my ears pop every time I come down here. Sometimes they don't pop at all, which can be quite annoying. This corner's good. Oh, fucking hell. I like this corner. It's a bit of an decrease in radius. But it's nice. Beautiful scenery. Now it gets to back to normal sort of streets. There's always cops on this road, so. Oh, a few good corners. The long sweepers here are brilliant. I think this is Southport Narang Road? Or something like that? Or Narang Marillenbo? I don't know what it's called. Once again, somebody else will find out and let everyone know, because fuck. Maybe I'll put a link in the description that shows the Google map. Oh, beautiful, huh? That shows the Google map route that these roads are, and you can figure it out for yourself. But yeah, I try to go this way at least once or twice a week, depending on the weather and how I'm feeling and if I wake up in time to get to work in time. But it's a good way to know, wake up and get a bit of a ride in. It's about half an hour's worth of riding. Adds about 25 minutes to my daily commute. So it's not too bad. Beautiful location. It's always a bit cooler as well, so in the summer this will be great when it gets really hot. I'll just come off the mountain and cool off a bit, really. Oh man, here comes. Ah, fucking hiccups. I don't try to go fast here, I just sort of stick at a certain speed and just do the whole road that way. Especially on the straights, I sort of slow down a little bit actually, because, well, I mean, it's fun going fast, but fuck getting a fine for it. I'd rather be going fast in the corners, it's a bit more fun, and, well, anybody can go straight in that, anybody can go straight, that's true. Everybody can go fast in a straight line, so do it at the drags. If you want to go fast in a straight line, do it at the drags. At least that way you can time yourself and see how fast you are. And that's the other thing, there's always traffic on this road too, so... The other thing about these corners, they're not single curve corners. I work in road design and that sort of stuff, so I sort of know what I'm looking at. And yeah, they're just sort of like three or four corners stitched together, sort of the same radius but slightly different, so it changes. That's why you sort of see me weaving in and out of the corners. Like, I set up for the corner, but like halfway through it or a third of the way through it, it'll change to a different radius and then change again and then change again. These are old roads that were built years and years ago before, like, you know, GPS and CAD, essentially. So it was all done by hand and by eye, and I wouldn't say primitive, but by more basic. Like, they did really good with what they had. Like, nowadays, all this would be one perfect curve because it'd all be mapped out by a computer and GPS and, you know, laser sights, laser leveling and all that sort of stuff. But when they made these, yeah, that was a different era. And yeah, I usually get stuck behind cars going this way. Usually up, actually going up the mountain. I was surprised that there were no cars there. Get stuck behind any cars there today. That was fortuitous. Yeah, looking at selling my prisms. If you go to my page on Facebook, you will see I have advertised them. I have two Sena prisms going for sale. See if you can find the post and if they're still for sale and you want to buy some, go for it. I'm looking to get a Hero 5, and because I just want a bit more, like I want Super View and I want 4K. This only has 1080p. I mean, they work awesome for what I use them for and I love them, but I want to do more family oriented video stuff. And I'm also moving into other things, like just recording stuff that I do rather than just on the bike, mainly for myself and for the family, sort of, you know, make family videos for the family that's overseas. So I'm looking to sell them. If you're interested, drop me a line and I'll let you know if they're still for sale. What else? Yeah, selling all my drone stuff. I bought all the bits and pieces, like to make a couple of drones, built one, flew it twice. That was like 6 months ago now. Have not had a chance to fly it. So I'm selling all that stuff as well. It was fun, it was good, it was hard. But I just don't have the time for it. There's other stuff I'd rather be doing. Recently I've started going fishing with my son, so, and he's loving it, so I'd rather be doing that than tinkering around with the drone that he won't be really able or interested in doing for a few more years, maybe 5 years down the track. We'll get into that again. In other news, I'm expecting my second child early next year. That'll be fun. Two boys, it will be a boy. So that sort of takes away on the drone time as well. Still be able to do fishing, I reckon. Just take little Bubsy along once he's a bit older and he can just sort of play in the sand while Daddy and his brother fish. And we've come to an overtaking area. Quick overtake. There's no point in overtaking on the doubles. This road isn't too interesting, so I'm not really missing out on too many crazy corners. Anyhow guys, thanks for sticking around and watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I don't usually post videos of me riding at any kind of speed. And that was just my daily, one of my routes I can take to work. I'm just wearing my jeans and my Kevlar hoodie. So I'm not doing anything too crazy. I'm not going fast or anything, so don't, you know, don't get your panties in a bunch. The scraping you heard, if you heard it, is from it's from my boots, nothing else. Yeah, thanks for watching guys. And as always, be safe and ride safe, and I'll see you guys next time!
Between my legs, call me an ugly woman and take my picture to show all the people you work with! Now pull up my scrotum and take the shampoo bottle out of my ass. Pretend I'm the pizza delivery guy and watch me whack off. Strap on a dildo and make me give you head. Tell me to slow down and do it at a medium pace. Oh, I feel so humiliated, I'm about to blow my load. You tell me it's time to make love, but now I can't, cause I spewed all over myself.
Then you look into my eyes, and you realize how much I enjoy loving you. Whoa. I'm so sorry I spunked on my stomach. Maybe next time I'll be better at loving you. Oh.